it had the effect on me of re-examining all my values, as it were, about life and death and so on, you know? And that's what I want to try to talk about. And it will be kind of a surprise to myself.
I was having a conversation with my life coach yesterday, and she suggested that I was telling her my saboteur was my evil twin. She suggested that I write that down on a rock. So I did. I wrote it down along with the things that were bothering me, that have been bothering me. And I tossed that evil twin into the ocean. You're a real pain in the ass. You really are. I tossed my evil twin into the ocean and drowned him. He's holding me back from the big life I want to have. He keeps my life small. So I symbolically tossed him into the ocean and drowned him. He's gone. Can't breathe. Dead. Destroyed. Feels good.
My head.
I'm talking about this idea in your head of it. You know, when there's no possibilities, there's
I'm
no
stagnant.
Space.
I'm stagnant right now because all I can feel is my messed up body. That's all. I'm consumed by it, day and night. The minute I wake up, the minute I go to bed, probably even in my sleep, I'm consumed by all the physical change that hasn't been for good. It's been for not bad, but definitely problematic, the pain. You know, that's what I think about a lot. And then in the midst of that, I got this job that I got to keep showing up for, which is getting harder and harder to do all the time, to show up.
I'm sporadically
amused by what I do sometimes, and the other times I wonder why I'm there.
Well, that's interesting. So I'd like to know what areas of your life you show up for and what areas of your life you don't show up for.
We're going to see a somatic healer. And where are we now? Of course, we're at a medical clinic while Roger can have somebody listen to his lungs and then get some more pills.
I can take him like this, Joe. Bleep. One capsule, three times a day. I did ask the important question, can I drink wine? So just don't drink too much. You can do it. Okay. Just swallow one of these down.
Why don't you take two? If one works well, two will probably work better. I'm a big believer in that. I like to double up.
So goes the pill-popping era.
One day my friend Roger was standing in the kitchen when he realized he couldn't speak or move his arm. A simple irregular heartbeat created a small blood clot which led to a stroke. I asked myself, what if the stroke was a message for Roger to start living his life fully instead of letting life live him in a way that is no longer true for him? I ask myself, why does it often take a painful experience to create change in our world when inspiration and beauty should pull us there naturally? Life is mysterious. I know in a heartbeat everything can change, for better and for worse.
If a clot forms and escapes from the heart, it can create a blockage in a blood vessel supplying your brain, cutting off blood and oxygen flow to the connecting area. This can result in the tissue death, or in other words, a stroke.
Everybody has a big vital question in their heart. I wonder, when would be the right time to start asking this question? Roger and David are asking them now. Nothing less than enlightenment is their goal, and the territory they'll explore is a roadmap to the human heart.
So Roger's heart problems seem related to his inability to find his authentic kind of self.
You know, I didn't have to lay there and say and be told that I need to take this, I take that. It's the fact that they present upon you the chances of you dying, that it frightens you into needing to do these things. And that's where I lay for the week that I was dealing with it initially.
I'm sure on some level he wishes he could have, like, healed himself. He could have, like, you know, gone to a naturopath or done meditation and worked it out. But instead he's gone the route of the burning and cutting, and hopefully it works for him, you know? But I don't think, even if it does work, it doesn't solve his essential problem.
Go, please.
So, how would I heal my heart, or how do I think I'd heal my heart?
I think I'm just like, I like to kind of keep it general, because I don't want to draw a specific answer out of you. I think it's whatever you make out of the question, how do you heal the human heart?
God, that is such a huge question.
And this is the GAC that I'm wearing the last 24 hours. What do you think of that? Anyways, all this stuff is hooked up and all the information is being recorded in this tiny little computer that's in here, and they're going to analyze it by tomorrow. And I'm going to have a meeting with the doctors at 1:00 Wednesday. And they're going to tell me, but for the life of me, I've done everything in my power in the last 24 hours to trigger the AFib. I ate too much, which is one of my symptoms. I drank myself silly. I got drunk by myself last night. I went for 2 hikes, running. I've done everything possible to set myself into AFib, and I still haven't gone into AFib.
You can't get it from your family and your friends a lot of times, right? They just want the old you, just the healthy old you. Just take the pills and get the operation and let's get back, you know, to our normal life.
Why do you have to be so adversarial?
Well, I don't understand what you're saying, so.
Well, that's because
as soon as I don't understand, I just disagree.
Yes.
I don't know, I feel there's one central mystery on Earth. There's one central question that informs everything else.
What is between here? This is the mystery.
Yeah, exactly. I don't know what's between there.
What is the mystery?
Well, it's the mystery of why we're here.
We're here to make money and buy a home and have kids, aren't we?
I don't know. Maybe. Maybe we are. I don't know. I think there's a lot more to it. I don't think this here is actually our home. I don't think we belong here. We're just temporary visitors. But we act like we're here forever, that this is all ours.
Still in transformation follows two friends as they ask themselves and others they meet on the road of life what is possible. Can they crack the code to a happier, meaningful life with all the obstacles and challenges that it presents? Is enlightenment just a theory, or is it something anyone can obtain in their lifetime? What is your big question, and how would it change your life if you asked it and lived your way to the answer? This film is both a request and an exploration. This is a story about three men who came together in order to uncover the truth hidden behind the many masks that we wear in our daily lives, to discover the mystery and possibility of the human soul. Roger is questioning life after experiencing a dramatic health crisis.
I want to know if we can heal ourselves. I want to know if that's built into our bodies already and it's something we don't tap into.
David is seeking to discover a deeper, richer essence of being and embark on a new life path.
The question of what a mistake is important. Perhaps there are no mistakes. There is no such thing.
Joe is a filmmaker who knows that the process of telling the story will fundamentally change him forever. An honest story creates change. It's the simple truth and its compelling energy that inspires us. It's the people we touch that, in return, touch us and shape our destiny. Will the journey bring them answers or only more puzzling questions? This isn't just our story. It's your story, too.